up on the keys or something.
Oh, well, sing it whatever you want.
I don't know how that works out.
And they have a little lady.
Just what I wanted to say, you know, say it to start.
I guess it's that time, you wanna take a handbook? Page 130? I suppose Stevie was willing to send a word for us.
Heavenly Father, we thank you more for this day, and I'm gonna be back in your house, Father. Thank you for them that have come out this way tonight. We just pray above all things, everything that be done tonight, God, would be, your name would be glorified. Father, we pray, Lord, if there's anybody here that's lost, that they get to know you and be part of sin. Father, be anybody here that's lost that joy in their life, God, we pray could be restored. Father, we just pray for the while you help us to worship you in spirit and truth. These favors we ask in Jesus' precious and holy name. Amen.
Long years ago.
Amen.
They like it to be, well, it's, you know, we'll see how it turns out. They like it to be kind of, they don't take any stock in a person standing and saying by faith in God's word and through the blood of Jesus Christ, I'm going to heaven.
That's right.
Because that makes them feel insecure about what they're prompting up on.
Yes.
And I just want to say tonight, in 2017, I had a meeting and an introduction with this Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, 30-some years ago. And all it was 2 o'clock in the morning, and I was by myself in that trailer. It changed my life. And I've been telling everybody about that day since then. Everything I've tried to do just says thank you. I'm not trying to pay him back or earn what he gave me, because it was a gift. But I go back to that night when he found me, when he was looking for me, when it was the greatest day of my life.
Amen, brother.
And the older I get, and the more I see myself coming short and failing, the greater I exalt what he did on that cross when he said it's finished. Amen.
He got it, brother.
I'm not going to forget that day. These people today that they're baking everything, they're investing everything in these baseball teams, they're investing everything in their stocks, they're investing everything they got in some worldly thing that could crumble at a moment's notice, that can be here today and gone tomorrow. Friend, what are they going to do? Brother Stevie talked about it this morning. Amen. One of these days, the Bible says it's appointed unto men once to die, and after this the judgment. Amen. One of these days, suddenly eternity, and suddenly there's going to be no option. There's going to be no, well, maybe I'll think about it. It is done. Amen. We'll stand before their holy God and hear the words, depart from me, I never knew you.
That's right.
But because there was a day, because he called and I answered, because he allowed me to have that measure of faith that he gave every man, and I put it in the right place in Jesus. Jesus, amen.
Amen.
Jesus said, what do we do the works of the Father? Believe on him whom he has sent. Amen. That's what pleased God.
Yes.
God has to be the originator of it.
Amen.
Without that spirit, man can't work it up. Amen. And I'm telling you tonight, I have been in the presence of some really good preaching. I've heard some really good singing in my lifetime. But friend, it took the Holy Ghost of God to convince me and convict me of my lost condition. I saw myself utterly without hope, hopeless and helpless, and God reached down to me and presented Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
And that's why I say, I never shall forget that day.
Amen.
No one else may ever remember it. And I'll never be on anybody's top 10 list. But thank God I made the roll in heaven that night when I accepted Jesus.
That's right.
Sometimes in my van or in my car or in my bed, me and God just have a time. Because I think about how he rescued a poor, lost, hell-deserving sinner.
He did.
And saved my soul.
Yeah.
Happy to go to heaven.
Yep.
God bless you.
Oh, sinner, come to Jesus now at his dear feet. Just come and confess to him your every sin. He'll stay. Shine upon the real thing, it looks better. the imitations look better from afar. Amen. They look good because they dress it up and they frame it, and everything's got to be in the right light.
Yeah.
But you know, this thing works good in the battle. It works good in the valley. Yes, it works good in the dark. And it looks better in the light. Amen. Because it's God breathed. Amen. Amen. Someone have anything else on any song or any request tonight?
I would not be denied. That's on 382 at the bottom. Off of
382.
Yeah. I would not be denied.
Bless you. Just pray for me. I ran off and left my glasses.
Bless you, Lord.
It's in there. Oh, you know what? I'm looking at the top song.
No, it's the bottom. I believe that.
I believe it's. Faith. We might as well, we all showed up, we might as well have church, amen.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord.
Ain't that somehow the devil works? He'll talk you out, try to give you excuse in the world not to go to church.
Yeah.
Then when you get there, he'll try to tell you, well, there's not enough people to have church.
Yeah.
And then you start doing something, he'll tell you how odd and how strange and everything else you are. And I'm just thinking, you know, he's a liar and the father of it.
Yes.
You know, he even got better things to do than go bugging on me and stuff. But you know what? That just goes to show me, you know, he just have to stop anything.
Yeah.
Just to bring glory to God.
Yeah.
Amen. And I can understand if we were at a big, even a gospel concert tonight, and everybody in the spirit was real high and everybody was good. But you know what? The world just can't understand a pan full of people getting together and pulling out a few instruments and lifting up their voice and starting to praise God.
Yeah.
They don't get that. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. But God receives it when we do it in His name. Ain't that good? Living by faith. I care not today what the morrow may bring, if shadow or sunshine or rain. In the Lord I know you, the day are in pain, when all of my worry is vain.
Oh,
I else tonight.
Have fun with the Lord.
Steve, I'm glad for services like this. And you can feel the Holy Spirit. And you can't work up a service like this. But there's a sweet spirit in here. And I thank God for Holy Ghost conviction, the Holy Ghost testifying and preaching. And I thank God for all of it. Raised up in it. And sin I was living, the fog was I given, and a time where I would go. I was searching, so hard was I trying to gain all this world had to own. And no peace, no pleasure could I even measure all I had to gain. I repented and prayed, God saved me that day. Now I got something to say. Well, I'm not going to hell. I'm meant to save you. My story I tell. I'm saved and forgiven. We all is well. I'm not going to hell. Christ, you made a change in me. I no longer cry when I think about dying, cause heaven is waiting for me. Now Satan is lying, and he's always trying to lead you down the wrong way. Just call in Christ's name, he'll save you today. Look back, Satan is saved. Well, I'm not going to hell. I'm meant to save your story I tell. I'm saved and forgiven. So free all is well. I'm not going to hell. No, I'm not going to hell.
Safe because they haven't said no, but they haven't said yes. They don't have a promise. So the song addresses that, so don't leave them hanging. There's a pathway that's leading to a cross or a hill. And if you've never traveled,
bless the Lord,
this pathway. You'll stand there looking at the price paid for you.
Yes, amen.
Will you receive it, take it or leave it? Which one will you do?
God bless you.
Don't leave him hanging and just walk away. Don't wait any longer.
Turn with me tonight to John, Gospel of John, 6th chapter. We're just going to do our best to learn some more tonight and try not to keep long. The message has always been the same. Preach from Genesis to Revelation, the message is still the same. You need to come to Jesus.
Amen.
Yeah.
It's the same message. You can deliver it in many different ways, Brother Johnson, but the message is still the same. The meaning is still the same. At least it should be.
Yes.
So you need to come to the Lord. And sitting there this afternoon on the front porch, meditating and praying, and the Lord brought some scripture to our hearts. And we'll just give it what God has put on our heart tonight. John 6, beginning of verse 66. The Bible says, from that time many of his disciples went back and walked no more with him. And said Jesus unto the 12, will ye also go away? And Simon Peter answered him, Lord, to whom shall we go? Thou hast the words to eternal life. And we believe and are sure that thou art that Christ, the Son of the living God. And that's all we want to read. Tonight you pray. We'll just do our best. My Lord, we may go back in the Old Testament some tonight. I just don't know. Just going to wait upon the Lord here for just a few moments here. But I was thinking the other day, coming up the road, just meditating on things, and what I'm about to say, I hope nobody takes offense to it, because I don't mean it that way, but as a church, you've got the church, if you will, amen, and then you've got the church, if you understand what I'm saying. Sometimes there are those... Brother Terry, maybe 5 or 6 folks, maybe some places there's more than that, 15, 20, 30, that really really carry a church, if you know what I'm saying, amen.
Amen.
And a lot of people don't understand, or I guess they don't appreciate what a job that really is, to that God depends on his people to do such a thing for him.
Amen.
And the gospel here tells us that he had talked to them, and he said, we also go away. No doubt, at that time, there was many, Mark, that had turned and walked back on God and walked away from him, on the Lord. And Jesus had looked at his disciples, and he said, we also go away. Peter said, Lord, to whom shall we go? Thou hast the words of eternal life. And I've often wondered, in the day and the time that we're living in, and I can't speak for you, I can only speak for myself, but Mark, I'm not proud of it by any means, but there was a time that I did turn my back upon the Lord, amen, and brother, not proud of that one bit, but I'm very proud and very thankful of what God brought me out of, amen,
amen.
And I'm sure we've all got our own story one way, shape, or form, amen, but Peter told them, he said, Lord, to whom shall we go? Thou hast the words of eternal life. And we may kind of go along the same lines as to what we did this morning, I guess. We preached about how long so you can pass this mountain, and we may hit a little bit of that. It may kind of go hand in hand. I don't know. But I thought a little bit, I talked some about it this morning. So many times the children of Israel would get out there, and time and time again, Brother Terry, the Lord would do a miraculous thing for them, and then they would find themselves once again in need of something, amen. And instead of Mark looking to God, the one that already made the way for them, they would begin to murmur, Brother Johnson, and complain when they found themselves in that position, amen. And I said it many times before, the number one death in the old Bible, reason of death, was murmuring against God. Amen.
Yeah.
Murmuring and complaining. And I thought this afternoon, as God brought me this passage of Scripture, I thought about how that they had come to the Red Sea there. And we'll just hit this. And there's another spot back in Isaiah I'd like to get to if God will help us. But I thought about how they were standing at the Red Sea there. Brother Terry, they had left Pharaoh and all of his armies and all that, had let the children of Israel go, and they were fleeing from Pharaoh is what they was doing, and you pray for just a minute, but they were fleeing from Pharaoh, and they got to the Red Sea, and no doubt the Scripture tells us that there was a many of them, Mark, that said, what have you brought us here for? We would have been better off in Egypt to just die back then, amen, and God spoke to Moses and said, Moses, he said, Moses, what is in thy hand? And he said, amen, a staff's in your hand, amen, rod's in your hand. He said, smote the waters, did he not, Brother Terry? And the Bible says that the waters was divided, Mark. And there was a way provided, amen, for God's children. Let me tell you something now. God's not going to bring you to something without a way of getting through that tonight. Amen. It's just that plain and simple. He said, cast the waters from, amen, divide the waters. So Moses did that. Amen. As God commanded him to do it. He parted, amen, the waters that night, and the Bible said, Brother Johnson, they began, amen, to cross over. The Bible says, Brother Terry, they passed over on the dry ground, is what they crossed over. Let me tell you something, not church, amen, popular, amen, against popular belief today. But when God does something, church, he does it the right way. Amen. They started crossing over. Amen. And you know what they were doing? As they was crossing over, how they were looking backwards is what they were doing. Amen. They seen Pharaoh and his army.
Bless the Lord.
Amen. Heather showed me something today. Amen. She's seen on the old Facebook world. It said, you know why God is bringing you, amen, through the waters? It's because the enemy don't know how to swim. Let me tell you, you may not understand the way God's bringing you, but I'm here to tell you, this evening, church, amen, I don't care if there's just 10 of us here tonight.
Lord.
Amen. As
Amen. But let me just tell you this. Amen. Whether there be 10 of us. Amen. Or how many. Amen. I don't know about you. But I got nothing, Brother Johnson, or to look back to. Amen. I've got my eyes looking forward. Amen. I'm looking towards Jesus Christ, the author and finisher. Amen. Of my faith tonight. Oh, let me tell you something this evening. Amen. The children of Israel. Amen. Went in circles for 40 years. Amen. Time and time again. They found themselves looking back. I got news for you tonight. Terry, I don't know about you. There ain't nothing back here in my former life. Brother, that I miss one bit. Lord, you're back. I've gotten a whole lot better since I found Jesus Christ as my personal Savior. Let me tell you something tonight, church. We've got something to thank Him for and praise Him for. Let me tell you, amen. Amen. The word came to a man named Hezekiah in the book of Isaiah. He was on his deathbed, Terry. He had a boil. Amen. He was ready, amen, to die. Yes, he was. You know what Hezekiah did? Hezekiah, Brother Johnson, didn't go see a therapist. He didn't tell him of all of his problems. He didn't go down, amen, the local bingo hall. Amen. Brother Mark, and tell him his problems. Amen. You know what Hezekiah did? The same thing that God's people need to do today. Bible says, Brother Terry, amen. He turned himself under the wall and he cried out to God. Hey God, oh glory to God. God heard Hezekiah's prayer. God answered his prayer. If we will turn our heart under the wall tonight and cry out to God, He'll hear from heaven.
Bless the Lord.
He will answer us. Amen. You believe that?
Yes,
this evening. Let me just say this for just a minute. Amen. And the Bible says, amen, that God came to Isaiah. He said, Isaiah, he said, you go tell Hezekiah, amen, that I've heard him. Amen. He said, this shall be to him a sign. Amen. That he knows I've heard him. He said, when he sees the sun dialing back,
bless
he
the
said,
Lord.
No. Amen. His prayers have been answered. Our brother Terry, I'm inclined to believe. Oh, Hezekiah, he was on his deathbed now, church. I believe he was laying in bed that night. Amen. I believe he was laying there. And I believe he's saying, oh, the sun began to set, Brother Terry. Amen. And about that time, amen, when there was no more light, about that time, she rolled back 10 degrees. I'm here to tell you tonight, the girl can still do the same thing tonight if we'll believe it.
Amen.
We need to stop looking back. I'm looking forward to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Let Him alone tonight. Amen.
That's good preaching.
Bible said, He lengthened His days 15 years.
Bless the Lord.
Amen.
Bless the
Lord. Oh, Hezekiah was thankful.
Yes.
Was he not? For what the Lord had done for him. Amen. He goes on to say, Brother Mark, a little later in that chapter. Amen. You know what it says? Amen. This is what I wanted to get to. Amen. The Bible says he told him, Hezekiah said, he said, I, amen. In other words, I was bound for a bottomless pit.
Yes.
Amen. He said, let me tell you something. Have God delivered me out of it. Amen. He said,
amen.
Let me tell you. He said, death, amen, has nothing to praise over. Amen. None of this has anything. Amen. Amen. The praise over. But you know what Hezekiah said? Hezekiah said, I of the living Terry, have something to worship God for tonight. We got something to worship for. Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
We got something.
Praise God.
to press towards tonight.
Yes, we do.
Amen. Bible said a man holding on to the plow and looking back is not fit for the kingdom of God.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. Y'all know what happened to Lot's wife.
Yeah.
Amen. They brought him out of Sodom and Gomorrah.
Yeah.
Mark, she stopped, she turned back.
No.
Did she not?
Yeah.
Bible said she was turned into a pillar of salt.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Church, let me tell you something tonight. Amen. It's tiring sometimes, Terry. Amen. And I got to go to work tonight, brother.
Yeah.
Amen. It's tiring. Let me tell you something. I don't understand what's wrong with people today. I really don't.
That's
why they don't want the joy that Jesus Christ has to offer them. Amen. Let me tell you something this evening. Amen. Terry, you've been real easy. I'd rather not even come tonight. Amen. Just packed my bag. Amen. Went on down the road. Amen. Let me tell you something. Amen. God's given us a job to do, brother. Oh, we need to do it to our best of our ability and not lose. Look back.
Bless him, Lord.
Amen.
Bless him, Jesus.
Lord, have mercy. Let me slow down for a run out of me tonight. Do you remember tonight, church? Do you remember so many times the children of Israel would complain and murmur and whine because of the spot they got to?
Yeah.
They would chide against Moses. They would chide against Aaron.
Yeah.
Against all of them. You know what thing I wanted the most? Even when God fed them manna, Terry, they still complained.
Amen.
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 Even if you go back to when the bad things, the nasty stuff, if you will, that they was eating, I call it that because it wouldn't be real pleasing to my appetite. Amen. And God still provided for them. And they began to eat manna and everything else. And they still complained against God because they wanted to look back.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Let me tell you something tonight, church. I can't speak for you. I cannot speak for you tonight. But there's nothing in my past, Terry, that I want to go back to.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah.
God has delivered me and brought me out of so much tonight.
Amen.
Amen. That alone, Terry, we ought to be able to shout the roof down. And thank God. I thank God tonight. I'm not the man I used to be. I'm glad when He saved me. He changed me, glory to God. He put love in my heart tonight. I've got a reason, like Hezekiah, to praise Him tonight. A preacher, what are you looking forward to? Let me just tell you, other sisters, talk about it. This morning, I'm looking forward to one day after a while, when God calls my number, I get to lay my old Bible down.
I'm
not preaching no more. Won't have to pray no more. Won't have to worry about faith.
Yes.
I won't need to no more. We'll be with the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
When I lay it all down,
yes,
that's the time we can let up, church.
Yes.
Thank
Not
you, Lord.
Not till then. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Not till then.
Help them,
Jesus. There's a community around us.
Yes.
There's a community around us that needs to be saved.
Yes.
If we went just as far as our own family, if we could get our own family in the house of God, we'd have to set folks and chairs out for them to hear the gospel of Jesus Christ. Amen. Let alone stepping out into this community. Amen. Let me tell you something tonight, church. We don't need to look back. We need to look forward tonight. Amen. You know what Paul said? Paul said, I press toward the mark of the high calling. That word press means, Brother Terry, I'm not quite there.
Amen.
Amen. I'm not where I used to be, but I'm not quite there. I'm pressing toward that mark. Amen. Preachers, there are going to be difficulties and troubles and trials that beset us as we go that way. You better believe it.
Amen.
There's going to be. Let me tell you something tonight. Whenever you try to do good, evil is going to be present. Amen. But as long as we're pressing toward Jesus Christ tonight, if God brings us to it, Mark, He ain't going to leave us there to dry. Amen. Amen. He's going to grab hold of us, whether we like the way or not, and bring us through it, glory to God. Or are we going to be like them that, when He talked to His disciples, that leave Him? Amen. Peter looked at him. Christ said, "Wilt thou go away again?" Also, Peter said, "Lord, to whom shall we go? Lord, you've got the words to eternal life.
Yes.
Lord, we've seen everything you've done. What good's it going to do us to go to anybody else? You've got everything we need tonight." Yeah. Amen. Yeah. Church, let me tell you something tonight. And I know what I'm preaching. I'm preaching to the church tonight. Amen. I know that. But we can't look back.
Nope.
We got to look forward.
Yes.
We've got to look forward.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. There's going to be some battles along the way. Amen. But you know what? When the battle gets a little strong, you know what we'll have to do?
Let's
pray just a little bit harder.
Amen.
Amen. You want to know why Jesus Christ was able to do so much on his feet? Because he spent ample time on his knees. Amen. Spent ample time praying. Amen. God told Hezekiah, he said, "Get your house in order." He said, "Because you're going to die."
Yeah.
Amen. Hezekiah turned to the wall and began to pray. And I've often wondered, and when I thought about this today, I believe Hezekiah was a good man. Amen. But I've often wondered, I thought about that verse. How many times, I believe when Hezekiah prayed that day, Terry, I don't believe it was one of them old same vain repetitious prayers,
no,
brother. I believe he cried out to God.
Yeah.
I believe that, Brother Johnson. I believe he cried out to God. But how many times do we find ourselves doing that same prayer of weeping and crying out to God only when things are at their very worst?
Yeah.
Amen. Yeah. I've often wondered how much better our lives would be, Mark, if every day we had that mindset. Amen. That we put our face toward the wall and cried out to God, saying, "God, help me. Help me, Lord." Because, Terry, I don't know if I'm going to leave for work tonight, brother. I don't know what I'm going to face tonight or tomorrow. Amen. Amen. But I know one thing. I don't leave him here at church when I leave Sunday night.
Amen.
But
amen.
I'll take him with me.
Yep.
Yeah.
Mark, because you never know when you're
going
to
leave. Yeah, that's right. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Tell you something tonight, church. We can't look back. Amen. And I'm going to take a step farther. Nobody else wants to go forward. I'm going forward. Amen. I'm going forward. Amen. So many people are walking in circles, like I said this morning. They're walking in circles. And they're looking back, wondering why they can't get no traction. I don't want to be like that.
No.
I want to do everything God would have me to do.
Yeah.
Amen. Whatever he'd have me to do. Amen. I'm looking unto him, the author and the finisher of my faith. I'm looking towards him tonight is who I'm looking for. Amen. Because one of these days after a while, amen, if time tarries and we see the Lord come back, amen, that's who I'm going to look for.
Amen.
When he comes, Terry, and guess what? When he calls, when we see him step out, if we
yes,
go that
Lord.
Way, amen. If the church goes that way, amen, if he calls and we leave here to go and join him in according to the
amen.
Scripture, what it tells us, brother, I don't know about you, but I'm not looking back.
Amen.
Because when he takes me out of here, there'll be nothing I need to return back to.
Amen.
Everything we'll ever need will be with him forever.
Amen.
Amen. We need not look back tonight.
Touchable.
We need to look forward. And we need to look forward and hold on to God.
Amen.
Amen. Because church, he's the only one.
Yeah.
The only one that can help us tonight. Amen.
Amen.
He's the only one that can help us.
Listen.
Hezekiah's life was spared and God answered 15 more years of his life. Amen. I believe God looked at his life and seen who he was. And seeing the cry and the prayer that Hezekiah prayed unto God. Amen. That's how we need to pray, Brother Johnson, every day of our lives.
Amen.
Not just when things get going bad, Mark.
That's right.
But every day of our lives.
Amen.
And if we'll do that, spend more time praying, maybe a little bit more time fasting. Amen. We'll see the difference in our life. Amen. And God will make the difference.
Yes, he will.
For us tonight. And we've got nothing to look back to. But I've got everything to look forward to tonight, amen?
Amen.
Amen. Stand your feet tonight. Lord, that way, Miss Lord. Get your song tonight.